Over the last 3 months, I would say I made close to $15,000. So probably,
in a 2 month period.
In a 3 month period.
In a 3 month period, $15,000.
Yeah.
That's amazing. So congratulations. Congratulations. So you could easily say, I'm not going to be held liable to the FTC. I'm just kidding.
No,
you made $15,000 in 90 days. So we can say about a little less than $6,000 a month if you were to like divide it up.
Yeah. I'm the champion. I cannot be stopped. I can't stop. I can't. This is my world. It cannot be rocked. You can't rock my world, son. Took a lot of work just to reach the top. Did a lot of climbing that I made it. Good luck to those who want to see me fly. I'll be number one for eternity. Wanna thank everyone who helped me get here.
What is up, everybody? How you doing? Michael Bashi here. And today with me, I have Jon McNeill. He is a Your Web Traffic Agency client, student, and a friend. And I have a little thing about him here I'm going to read out to you just so you get a little bit more information of who Jon McNeill is. Jon McNeill is a seasoned affiliate marketer with a passion to help others make money online. Jon is a regular guy that loves his family, basketball, and internet marketing. Jon is someone who's determined to reach his goals no matter what the obstacles or setbacks he encounters. Jon is all about taking consistent action, having a positive mindset, and a don't quit attitude. And I'm not lying about that. You can go to his website and you can read it there. Jon joined Your Web Traffic Agency about 4 months ago from the recording of this video, and he is here to tell you all about his experience and results. So, Jon, welcome. Nice to have you here, and thank you for agreeing to do this.
Oh, no problem. Thank you for having me, and thanks for that lovely intro you put together for me.
Well, I mean, you kind of helped, too. I got some of it from your actual website, so
okay.
Thank you. Okay.
No problem.
So
glad to be here.
Are you ready to get grilled? I'm just kidding. Are you really ready? Very simple stuff, honestly. Just that's why I thank you for coming forward and agreeing to do this, because sure. As people will know throughout this is not planned. It's not scripted. It is for me. I have all the questions I'm going to ask you, but you have no clue what I'm going to ask you. You even told me not to even send it to you.
Yeah.
So it's just two real men talking. And I just want everyone to, get a feel of your experience and how things went and say the good and the bad. Okay.
Yeah,
so not just good things. All right.
Yeah.
So let's get started. So first and foremost, how did you find out about Your Web Traffic Agency, and what made you decide to look into it to see what it is all about?
I think I found out about it initially from one of your YouTube ads, and I think you were talking about traffic and just being an affiliate marketer. There's always ebbs and flows in income, because you can have a great program that you're promoting and you can make a lot of money, and then that program can go under or just kind of sours out. And
of course, your video's cutting out. Do you have internet issues?
Did we lose recording here?
No, it's still recording.
I think I might.
You just cut out like 5-6 seconds ago, which is fine. See, that's what I meant. It's all raw, real, and it's all good.
Yeah.
just we don't have to redo anything. We can just continue.
Yeah, I'm just wondering if I do need to move locations just because I don't want it to continue to cut out.
Okay, if it does it one more time, we can change it up. Your video seems synced in, so you should be fine, I guess. But if you feel more comfortable, you can move. Up to you.
Okay. Well, we'll try. We'll see what happens. Okay.
See how it goes.
All right.
Which you answered some of it, is how did you find out about what Your Web Traffic Agency, and what made you decide to look into it and see what it's all about? And that's where we stopped. So you can continue on.
So I initially found out about your Web Traffic Agency from one of your YouTube ads. So being an affiliate marketer, there's ebbs and flows to this business, because there's different programs that you can be a part of and you can make a lot of money, but then those programs can kind of go out of business, or some products and services kind of get a little bit sour and you need the next product or the next program to continue to promote to actually make money.
And
so there's times where like
Yeah, there was times where I felt like there was nothing really good to promote that I really felt good about promoting. And I saw your video and it kind of struck me because I was just like, what does every affiliate marketer need? What does anybody in the business opportunity space and MLM space, whatever space they're in, everybody needs traffic.
So happens we serve that market because that's one of the biggest markets, but you don't have to be an internet marketer to want traffic. Everybody wants it. It just so happens that our niche is we provide the traffic to business opportunity owners, digital marketers, information marketers, and that's a huge market. It's a gigantic market. Oh, yeah. So, I mean, you know, goes hand in hand and it makes sense. But yeah, you're absolutely right. There are a lot of, see, that's the thing. This may sound like I'm not making sense, but you don't need a program to learn how to make money. You can have courses and stuff that teaches you. But what I mean is, in order to make money, it's not a program that's going to show you. The programs, they teach you, they educate you. But then you have to go and figure it out for you, because people are not magicians. They're doing their best to teach you. But then you have to go out there and figure out how it's going to work for you. So for me personally, this was a big thing for me when developing Your Web Traffic Agency. I'm like, how do I take that? And this was real. How do I take that out? I don't want to just sell you some teachings. I want to provide people with a way that where they can make money, and that way doesn't become or has a very hard chance of becoming oversaturated, because the demand is always bigger than the supply, so it doesn't matter. And how can I offer something where I'm not just teaching you, but I'm actually giving you something that is actually going to work for you and anyone else who does it? And I'm happy you hit on that point, because a lot of the programs out there, you said, it's kind of like they work for a little while, because that's it. It's like a program for that trend or that time that's going to work for a few weeks or a few months, and then it's just going to stop working. And that's not what you want when you're building any business. It doesn't have to be Your Web Traffic Agency. It could be anything. And I'm pretty sure that's how you build any business you get into too. Whether it be your courses, programs, whatever it is that you do. So that's glad you brought that up. Moving on.
Yeah, I mean, that's what definitely attracted to me, because I wanted to have something that no matter what I was doing, I wanted this sustainable income. And I just thought traffic is perfect because you can serve the masses with traffic. So
exactly. And it's not just that. You make your money from repeat customers. That's the other thing. It's not people always say, well, how can you I'm like, okay, well, with traffic, people will always buy some. It runs out. And if your traffic is helping them and it works, they're going to come back and buy more. So you're building your business off of repeat customers, not just off of, one-off sales or anything like that. So that's really what attracted me to create it for others. So I'm like, okay, this is perfect. So people, especially people that have a barrier to entry, which is, I'm not saying you, just people in general, when you have a barrier to entry where you don't know how to write copy, you don't know how to advertise, you don't know how to market, you're going to have a hard time getting sales, or you may get lucky and get a sale here, a sale there. But how can you sustain that if you're just starting out? It's going to become a hobby, not a business. But when you have the same people coming back as repeat customers, you're going to be like, okay, wait a second, this is real. I have customers, I have to and then you start taking it like a real business, because you see sales coming in from repeat customers. You're like, okay, this is cool. I think we touched on a lot. That's the shortest question. I hope the other stuff does. Okay, let's go through it. All right, next up is now. Okay, so here's the thing. Of course, the investment in Your Web Traffic Agency may be big or may be small for some. It all depends on the value, of course, that we are providing to our clients, and if they actually see and appreciate that value, knowing that it is not really offered anywhere else online for that price. And I checked, and it's really not. Right. So that being said, what was your first impression of YWTA, your web traffic agency, in terms of the investment, and what was going through your head before signing up? Like, when you saw everything, you know, you knew what the investment cost was. You didn't know who I am because we haven't spoken on the phone yet. And like, what was going through your head? What were you thinking?
Yeah. Well, I thought the value was there because I knew that you were getting just a business. It's not like you're buying it to something where it's just another trading, opportunity. Yeah. It's an actual business that can actually pay you multiple thousands and thousands of dollars every single month. So that was going through my head. So I knew that the value was there. Obviously, when you're spending that type of money, you have a little bit of hesitancy when you're going to be spending that kind of money. And what really kind of sealed the deal for me personally was when we actually got on the phone. So, you know, I actually kind of went through your funnel and, you know, I filled out the information and we actually got on a phone call. And I remember because I was actually on vacation at the time.
You were. And I was in the States, too, when we spoke, I think. Or I was headed there.
Yeah, I think you were. So I was on vacation. And I was literally like in front of a restaurant or something like that, having this call with you and just kind of getting all my questions answered. And so like that was very helpful for me in actually kind of making the decision because like I got on the phone with you. I was able to grill you in terms of your service timelines and quality and everything else. So that kind of sealed the deal. And I was just like, this is it. I got to go for it.
Yeah, and I mean, that's why I put the phone calls there too, because that's why I brought up the investment. Like, it depends on the value, right? Like, to some people, they're like, okay, this is a lot. To others, they may say, oh, this is cheap. And to others, they may say, oh, this is a lot. But you know what? It's worth it because I see why the investment is that much because of all the value that comes with it. So regardless on the hesitancy, like, it's not even that. It's not like I offer to speak to people for that reason, only because, and as you know, when we spoke on the phone, it's not like I was trying to sell you on the phone.
No, not at all.
It was a regular conversation. And it's not like I want to get you on the phone so I can say bye, bye, bye. It's like, I know some people, like they see the value. The investment may be a little bit, you know, maybe like they can afford it, but it just, you know, it's a big investment. So they want to talk to you before they actually seal the deal, so to speak. So getting on the phone and answering those questions, even if I answer it on video, usually helps. And that's why I like to put it out there so people see it. And I don't think anyone does that, like where you get on the phone and you're not actually selling someone. And again, I'm not tooting my own horn because I'm always comparing like the competition. Not that I care about the competition, because I know they don't do that, but I'm always looking to see what if somebody, you know, started doing that. So let me see what they're doing, how they are doing it.
It wasn't a pressure sales call at all. I mean, we just got on the phone and you answered my questions. You were very relaxed.
Yeah. And I think you were like on the go too. It's like, you were like, it was just a regular conversation.
Right.
So that was great. So now, what was your experience after you joined your web traffic agency? Meaning like, how was the process after and what was your experience with that? So like, we spoke on the phone, you're like, okay, this is cool, sealed the deal, I'm gonna sign up. Couple days later, I think it was, you signed up. So now what? Like, what was your experience now? You signed up.
When I came back from vacation, I think I signed up and then you basically sent me the emails and you sent me the training site. So you kind of let me know that it's going to be a few weeks before you actually kind of put all the business together, get your whole entire websites and everything together. So I was just kind of waiting around for it to be, you know, completed. And then during that process, I actually started going through the actual training that you had provided for us. So that was really good. And that's where even things started to click even more in terms of like how I'm going to actually run the business and manage the business and actually market the business as well. So it was all good.
Great. That's great. And the timing is different for like everybody, right? Because that's basically the whole point. While we're building it for you, you can go through the training. So once we're done, you're not wasting time still trying to figure things out. So you already know what you are getting. Now, of course, for some people, you know, they have other obligations, other things. It's not always going to work out that way. But basically, that's the general concept. So while we're doing our part, you're doing your part, going through the training so you understand what you're going to be getting as part of your business and so on. So that's great.
And okay, I took my time going through the training too. Like I really took my time because it was so much. It was overwhelming at first, but I was just like, I gotta, you know, take my time and kind of really consume this stuff in bite-sized pieces because I know it's at the end it's gonna really help me. So
it was really good. I mean, it's basically like because you need to learn how what your business is and what's going to what consists of. Because the more you understand it, the better you will do. And then you need to learn. Now you know what the business, like how the business will be set up. Now you need to know how to run it, how to market it, how to fulfill orders, how to do this.
All the technical pieces,
It seems like when we're talking about it here, I know it seems like a lot of work. Yeah. But actually, like, what was your experience like after you went through you got the business complete, you went through the training, like what was running the business and doing everything you needed to do as complex or as overwhelming as the training may have been when you first started going through it?
No, absolutely not. Like once everything was—
Be honest, like Jack, honestly.
Not just for the video. It's super easy. And I'm a super non-techie person. I talk about this all the time.
Wow, really?
Yeah, I'm not a technical person at all. So like it was super easy. Like once I got my forms, my click tracker, and then like my order intake forms, you kind of just play around with that a little bit. After my first couple orders, it was really like plug and play. And now I can almost do it in my sleep. It's so easy.
That's amazing. That's amazing. Yeah. I'm so glad to hear that. And
it's
that's
just overwhelming at first because you see in the training, there's a lot of training. It's brand new. You want to, make sure you get everything. But like once you do it once or twice, it's super easy.
Exactly. No, I'm so happy for that. And also like that's the other thing that I have a hard time like getting people to maybe, like comprehend this part. When I always say like, it's not just a website. Like we're not just building you a website. We're not web developers, just so you know. Like, we know web development, but we're like marketers. We're all about funnels and strategy and marketing and a sales process and getting people to buy. Like that's what we are mostly professional in, me and my team. Obviously we have to know some web development, but like, that's the thing. It's not— you're not paying for, quote unquote, for a lack of a better word, a website. You are getting a website, yes, but you get what I mean. Like, I have a hard time telling, like, this is a business. It's not just some
business.
Not just some like pages. You're getting a business with not just web pages, like you just mentioned, the tracker, checkout forms, which is the form where the orders come in. You get to see what the orders are to fulfill them. Yeah, so I'm very happy to hear that the whole process was easy for you and it wasn't complicated.
Yeah.
Okay, so enough about your web traffic agency, YWTA. Let's focus specifically on your agency business. When you received that email, which I think we just touched upon it now a little bit, when you received that email from me letting you know that your business was complete, what was your reaction? And again, I know you touched on it, so let's do it this way. Once you received that email, what did you do first? And what did you think of the setup? Like when you first, you got the email, now you get to go look at your business. So what was the thing that you did and what did you think of the entire setup?
Yeah, I was impressed. I was excited at first when I got the email saying that my business was all set up. And then when I actually went inside and, basically started looking at all the forms and all my web pages, it was exciting just because like, I had this small vision and you kind of brought it to reality. And I remember when I was thinking about my domain, trafficbyjohn.com, and then I saw my logo and I saw my ebook and I saw like my business and I saw like the income that I could generate from these clicks. And it was just super exciting. And basically I just kind of really took my time and I kind of went back through some of the training to make sure that I knew exactly what I was going to be doing and how to run the business and make sure I know how to, do the forms with the additional training you actually provided and like how do you actually input an order and set up.
And it was all easy for you to like go and check and see and log in and like
everything.
And probably because you went through the training prior to receiving that business, because that business model video where I show you where like everything is and what to do.
Yeah.
I don't know. Did that help? I mean,
Or
did you just get it because you kind of have a background knowledge of those things?
No, all of that helped. All of that helped. And all of the videos helped. And I think like that's one of the most important things you can absolutely do if you're going to get involved with this. You have to go through the training and take your time to go through the training because it's just going to help you out.
And tell people, do not skip. Go through it. Like go through it in order.
Just take your time. I mean, it takes you a few weeks to put the business together anyway. So it's just like you have plenty of time to go through it. And I would refer back at the beginning to some of the videos when I had questions about something. So I would just refer back. And now I don't need your training website at all. Like I'm fully functional.
Oh, there. I mean, if you want it, but
I don't know if you updated anything. You may be able to tell me, but I don't even use your training website.
That's amazing. Like, that's my first time me hearing that feedback, not just for this video. It's a good feedback for me to know that the way I structured the training is somewhat on the right path. Mm-hmm. Because that's my whole point. Like, the reason why I tell people don't skip the training, it's not because, see, most people do that in their programs because they want you to consume everything because, mm-hmm. because they're going to be selling you something later.
Sure.
They want you to understand what's going on and the information and so on and kind of like follow along. With me, obviously, that's not what I do. I'm not selling anything else in there. It's just your web traffic agency. But the way I structured the training, it is set up in a way where I need you to follow it step by step because every video or training where I put it, it's put there in that spot for a reason. I didn't just take a bunch of videos that I recorded and I just put it out there and say, you know, go watch it and, you know, figure it out. That's why even inside the members area, you see it says, do this, do that, step one, step two. Like, because I noticed some people were not following along. So that's why I ended up changing the members area where I didn't just put it in order. I actually told you it's an order. So like, do this first, then do that. Don't go here, go here first. Finally, people are, you know, catching on.
Right.
So that was good. All right. So again, this is kind of not that similar, but so now your business is complete and you have it. You received that email. You looked at everything. It was awesome. I'm glad you loved it, liked it. And then you went through everything, training and so on. You understood the funnel, the setup, how to get customers, the whole, you know, training, everything was good. So what was next for you after that? What did you do or how did you start running your business to get customers? So now you have it, you got it. What did you do to start getting customers? And your video cut out again for half a second, you're back on. You're good. It won't even show. Yeah. So
I did, before I actually started marketing my business, I did do one thing and I wanted to let your audience know. So, you know, when you set up your initial ebook and they opt in and then they have that OTO, which converts very nicely.
One time offer.
50%, right. 50% off that first package, that starter package. So one of the things that I did do is I did create a video kind of talking about what my service is all about, because I really felt
basically what you did. And you, I remember you asking me about this and I don't mean to cut you off. I'm so sorry.
Sure.
Because I do mention this too. So on that one-time offer page, we do create a sales video to sell the one-time offer. Okay. Yep. Like for you and you still have access to it. But what you decided to do, which I love, because you know, you make videos and you have your own YouTube channel. So you decided to make your own video and replace it on that page. Now, just for everyone out there really fast, and sorry, I don't mean to cut you, I just want to put it out there. It is a good idea if you want to put some skin in the game, so to speak, and like on those type of pages to make your own video. So you could kind of like, so it'll be more personal. That's the only reason. Not because your video will convert better or ours is not good. Our video is actually very good and it converts. But when it's more personable, when people get to the one-time offer and see you on video, even you don't have to be a marketer or a sales copy genius. You don't even have to script it. Just, hey guys, what's up? This is my one-time offer. This is what I offer. Reiterate what's already on that page. and just put it on YouTube and then just put it on your one-time offer.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter. But more personable over time, it will convert better for you because it's more personable, basically. Yeah. But the video we put out there also works. So you can use that too. So go ahead. Sorry, I don't mean to steal the shining light off of you. No, because this is all about you now. I want your experience, but I just wanted to put that out there because, again, people will find any excuse to say, oh, see, that's why it worked. He made his own video.
Right.
It's like, no, you don't.
No.
It's just more personable. That's all.
And it was like a 1 minute video, and I literally reiterated everything that was on the page and just kind of tell them who I was and just personalize it a little bit so it wasn't anything crazy or anybody can do it. So I did that, and you added that to the page for me, so that was perfect. And then from there, I actually wanted to try to start getting customers for free initially. So what I did was I do a little bit of YouTube marketing, and I have a YouTube channel, and I basically just went and did some keyword research on solo ads. So I actually kind of pulled up, and there's a lot of searches for solo ads, and there's different keyword terms that, you know, people are searching for solo ads. And then so I just kind of got that list of keywords, and I started kind of creating some short 3-4 minute videos around solo ads. And a lot of the stuff that you actually learn in your training, if you're going through the training, you're going to learn more about solo ads than you ever care to know. And so I would just start putting out that information on YouTube. And I actually started like getting interest, and then people started opting into my page, getting the ebook. They would see the one-time offer. And what I want to say about the one-time offer, it's so appealing to internet marketers, affiliate marketers, because it's cheap. You know, it's cheap. You're going to get 50% off that.
For the quality, it is cheap.
Yeah. Yeah. You're going to get 50% off that starter package. And a lot of people are going to, you know, quickly pull the trigger. And then once they get the quality of your leads, the service, everything that you do on the back end, the nurturing sequence, where you're following up, asking them about their experience and everything like that.
A lot of that stuff is also automated in the back once they're in your funnel now.
Yeah.
All the email follow-ups, the automation, they're now in your funnel. So they're getting all those emails. And how do you like the Aweber stuff where you got run one and run two? So the emails always, you know, cycle back. So you're never, the email follow-ups are indefinite. So it's never like they reach the end. Well, what do I do now? Do I need to add more emails? No, there is a tag and they go right back and receive the emails all over again.
All the automation is perfect.
Yeah.
And it's funny because like people will respond back and email me back to like certain emails that are going out. And it's like, well, let me see what this email is.
So yeah, so that's amazing. Yeah, and that's exactly, it's funny that you brought that up. Because I was editing my presentation video, the 1 hour one yesterday, and there was a portion where it says, you know, you don't even have to speak to your customers, just the occasional email they may send you to ask you a question here or there. And you just bring that up now. So I'm like, okay, cool. So yeah, that it matches, you know, which is basically, I get it from, you know, dealing with other clients. And so that's how I know, right? And me being a solo ad buyer and seller. Now, I like to call it email traffic. I do call it solo ads, but I like to call it email traffic too, only because a few crazy marketers out there gave solo ads a bad name.
True.
Where everybody thinks it's, you know, junk traffic, it doesn't work, it's all spam, it's all robots. Well, just because by three people, I mean probably like, you know, a lot more than that, but just because some people figured out a way of how to send bots to your site instead of real visitors doesn't make the actual traffic medium within itself bad. It's just those people. What they're doing is not even solo ads. They're just sending you bot clicks.
Bot traffic,
for, you know, 5 cents a click. And then you go there, but, oh, they're selling a click for 5 cents. Well, yeah, you're not getting real visitors. You're getting robots. You want robots? No one that's going to buy. Go get, you know, 10 clicks for 50 cents or 100 clicks for, you know, $5 and enjoy. It's not resulting in anything anyway.
Right. Email traffic has been used for eons and it'll continue to be used. Some of the biggest marketers in our space are using email traffic and email drops. So, it's an effective way to get traffic. Else,
but you're absolutely right. They buy, obviously, I get traffic from Google, YouTube, everywhere else, but if you really want like a lot of traffic one shot at once, it's email traffic, solo ads. You can't really get, there's no way you can get, you know, 10,000 visitors in a couple days, unless you're willing to spend like $50,000 or more on like YouTube in, you know, a couple days. And you know, you can't get that much traffic at an affordable price unless you're doing solo ads. And and honestly, it's like the best form of traffic. I love it. So that's amazing. I'm very glad. So, okay. So how did that, like, how did that go? You put out those videos and you started getting people. So what like happened? How did it start going?
Yeah. So I started getting the first couple clients and I started fulfilling the orders, and it basically happens just like you said, like you start getting those repeat buyers. So, I mean, I probably got like an initial surge of maybe like 20 customers or something like that. And then out of that 20, you maybe have 7-8 of those people that start to repeat.
Your numbers are actually high. Yeah. I would assume you would have said 3-4 of them. 7-8 is amazing. Honestly.
Yeah. Very good. So like 7 or 8 of them were definitely like repeat customers. And then basically you can get referrals too. So those people that are using you, I started getting referral business and they would say, hey, this person referred me to you. Can you send traffic for me? I'm like, of course I can. And so it just kind of builds on top of that, builds on top of that. And it really becomes kind of an autopilot business because like you can start, you know, I can continue post videos on YouTube. I can promote to my list. You can actually do paid traffic. And one of the great things about your program, you have multitudes of ways to get traffic, whether it's free ways, whether it's paid ways, you have a bunch of different ways that you can get traffic. And so that helped as well. So I kind of use a barrage of all of those ways to get traffic.
That's amazing.
I consistently get orders. I mean, it's kind of on a day-to-day basis that it's very infrequent where I don't get at least one order a day.
That's amazing. So glad to hear. And hopefully by the time this interview goes out, we put the link out for your site, your YouTube channel, whatever. Hopefully that brings more customers too.
I appreciate it.
Oh, of course, man. Thank you for, you know, doing this. It goes both ways. So this is, I don't think I wrote this here, but since it came up, I'm sorry to put you on the spot, but I have to ask this. Some people out there will be like, okay, well, yeah, you know how to make videos. You made a few YouTube videos and you put them out there and you know how to do keyword research. And this is why it worked for you. So what do you say to people that say, well, I don't know how to make, because now some people will think, oh, this is what I got to do. I got to make, you know, 5 YouTube videos to make it work. And if I can't do that, this is not going to work. And please, like, obviously, clearly you've been honest. So please say it raw and real. If somebody says, well, I can't make YouTube videos like John, so how do I make this work? What do you have to, or what would you say to someone like that?
You don't need YouTube. Like, YouTube was just my medium of trying to start to get free traffic. I mean, you have some great training on Facebook just by going into different Facebook.
All social media, yeah.
Right. And you can offer, I mean, I don't know how much you want to let go, but you can offer like free clicks essentially to start getting your first clients and then build on top of that. You have multiple different methods in terms of like getting clients. So YouTube is definitely not something that you have to do. There's paid ways. There's other free ways that you have in the training. So there's really,
and that's the thing. You don't have to be doing every single one of them in order for you to start getting customers. The idea is I'm giving a diverse ways of getting customers just so that people find what's comfortable for them. Because some people are like, okay, well, I don't want to do Facebook. That is fine. I teach you how to do it on Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter. I teach you how to do paid and free. And I actually have a couple trainings going out, which you haven't seen either yet, where I teach this stuff of getting customers with zero advertising budget outside of social media. There are so many ways you could do it outside of social media. It's not even funny. And I know you're very creative, so you probably have some ideas, but I'm going to put it on video because I'm in the process of working on it. It's going to go in the training. There is, like you said, multitudes of ways to get customers on a zero advertising budget. And if you want to do paid ads, I personally prefer people do what you did. Do it on a zero advertising budget first. Because once you get that repeat customer base. The only thing is, it's not really a problem, but a lot of my clients who started getting repeat customers from a zero advertising budget, they're like, the heck with paid ads. Why do I want to spend money on advertising?
It's hard to pay for
when building
you're doing
my business on a zero advertising budget. But the whole idea is, now you can play with the house's money if you want to do paid ads. So you're not putting money out of your own pocket. You can take the money you are making
and invest that.
You can take the money you are making and the profits from that, you could now put it to paid ads. And even if you're testing, or, you know, you lose some of that money, you're not losing money out of your own pocket. It's revenue that came in. But if I mean, if you don't want to, I have many clients who built $5,000, $6,000, $7,000. Some built $2,000. It's all what you want.
Yeah.
A month, a week, every couple weeks. I mean, of course, always going to be random. It's not like on the dot every month you're going to make $5,000. Sometimes that's your goal. It's going to come in 30 days, 32 days, 28 days, 2 weeks. It all depends on the volume that people buy. But what I'm saying is that it's doable with a zero advertising budget.
Oh, absolutely.
It's so doable. And actually,
I was also,
it works better.
And then
paid ads. Yeah.
And I was also going to say, like, there's ways, like, once you start getting people onto your list, you can actually advertise to them. So sometimes I'll start sending out emails and say, hey, I'm running a special this weekend. And I mean, you have that time to do anything
or whatever
that
you
want to do.
That's
amazing. I mean, you can sell them at 50 cents a click. So you can sell them at whatever. I run specials. I'm probably going to do a Black Friday special coming up for this Thanksgiving. You know, so I mean, you can tap into income essentially anytime you want.
On any occasion. And that's the thing with traffic. Like if you were selling a training or a course, if people already bought it, you can't run a Black Friday special to the people that already bought it. You can only run it to the ones that never bought it yet.
Sure.
And then you can try to get customers. But you can run all the specials to all your subscribers and your customers, because what? If they don't want more traffic for cheaper price, for a discount, everybody wants more traffic. Yeah. And that's what I love about this.
Yeah. You just tap into that.
Instant
income. Yeah.
That's amazing. I know. It's amazing. I love it. Okay. We're almost done. I'm sorry. I know I said it's going to be about half an hour. We've already gone beyond that. So this is a very important question I must ask for everyone watching this video once, obviously, it's published. So, and again, everything, because we talked off script, so I know you mentioned some of those things, but I'm going to say it anyways. Now, you know, it is human nature for people to find excuses. So people say, oh, but John got lucky. John has now an email list. John started at the right time. It worked for John. It won't work for me. Like, what do you, and again, I'm not putting you on the spot. I know you already touched on this, but I'm just trying to drill it down people's heads, like, stop procrastinating. No, I'm saying about business in general, not just YWTA. I'm just being real here. Yeah. I'm not, like, what do you have to say to people who are, like, thinking that way? Did you get lucky? Were you lucky? Did you start at the right time? You were going on vacation when we spoke. So what do you have to say about that?
I mean, I think the timing probably wasn't perfect for me, if I actually kind of really think about it, because I was on vacation. I was really busy at the time. But it just makes sense, guys. There's no reason why you shouldn't be able to do this business. So if you're a brand spanking beginner, you don't need technical skills. The business is done for you. And all you have to do is follow the training and implement. Follow the training and implement. Anybody can do this. And if you have any drive at all and you make an effort to do this, you can actually make money with this business. There's no reason you can't, because it only just takes a little bit of effort with all the different multitude of marketing strategies that you have in the back office. There's no reason why you can't start getting a few customers, and then a few customers start turning into like more customers and more customers.
And that's the whole point, the repeat customers.
That's where the money comes in at. It's crazy. Exactly. I mean, I have multiple people ordering every single week. We're talking 200 clicks, 300 clicks. And I mean,
so happy
it's
for you,
like
man.
Clockwork. Yeah, it's great.
That's amazing. That's amazing. this is a long and a fully loaded question, but it's simple at the end. So I'm just going to go through it here. I took my time writing these because I really wanted to, I didn't want to just ask random, you know, stuff. I wanted to, you know, to really know what I'm asking you, because we've spoken on the phone, on Skype. So I know who you are. I know how you're doing with the business. So I want it to be like more tailored to our experiences that we both had.
Sure.
So now I know from years of developing and refining the training for YWTA, which is an ongoing, never-ending task, obviously. I always do my best to give clients the tools to be able to just plug it in and literally start making money, because I make everything available for them, which what you already said now.
Right.
Now, I know you followed along the training, and not only are you getting customers, but you are also getting repeat customers. For anyone watching, what did you do to make the training now, to make the training work for you? Because clearly you're a human being, you're not a robot. You can watch and follow along, obviously, but the idea of going through a training is finding, that's why I give a diverse ways of like going along with getting customers, because I want people to find their own way. Because the more a way is comfortable for you, the better you will do.
Absolutely.
So basically, how did you make the training work for you, and what can others, like in your opinion, do to claim the training and the teaching as their own? So like find their own way and use it to start profiting as soon as possible or almost right away once they start. I want those who may be having a hard time or it's taking them too much time to get that first customer to listen to this and maybe pick up a few things from your experience, from the training, the business, so on and so forth.
I think you have to have, first and foremost, Mike, you got to have desire, right? You have to have the desire to do this business, because you can pay for it, you can go through the training, but if you're not like having the desire or you have like the discipline to actually take the steps to do what you need to do to start getting clients, then you're going to not succeed doing this. So absolutely, you got to have the desire. Absolutely. I mean, you made the investment, everything is there for you. So all you have to do is actually kind of follow the steps and figure out like what path you want to go down, whether it's going to be a paid, you know, traffic path, or it's going to be a free traffic path. And like you said, you can probably just start off doing it the free way and get your first couple clients and then go from there. But that's what I would really encourage everybody to do, is just, you know, give it your all. And once you start getting those first couple clients, this business is going to become very easy. I also would really
start
suggest
feeling
that,
it, because they're coming in.
And just communicate with your clients too. Like, that's something that I would definitely suggest in terms of just like emailing back and forth.
Because, and it's in the training like, too.
Yeah. Very simple questions. The script, and just like responding to them. All the scripts are there. Everything's in the training. And even after every traffic order is complete, I think the email automatically goes out. But I actually just send like a personal email saying like, how was your results? You know, do you need more traffic, et cetera,
How has your customers been reacting to your to the traffic you are sending them? Of course, not everyone who buys will become a repeat customer. I'll be an idiot to assume that people will think that. But again, the whole idea is, for example, out of the 20 customers that you've got at first, 7-8 of them became repeat customers. So what do people think of the traffic you were sending? You're back on. You cut out while I was talking, so you are good. Go ahead.
Okay.
So
have like a multitude of reactions. And so like you'll have some people that get the traffic and it's amazing and they got 40% opt-in and they made a sale or two. And of course, those people are just ordering more and more clicks. Then you have some people that will, you know, order clicks and they won't have a great opt-in percentage or they won't make any sales, but that's the solo ad business. And that's the kind of conversation.
Also depends on their funnel too and their business, not just your traffic, right? Because clearly your traffic can't be good and get sales for some and won't get any for others. Yeah. And then you say, well, your traffic sucks. No, if your traffic is good, your traffic is good. Sometimes it just the traffic, the audience, and whatever their funnel or their business is, even though it's in the same category, but it just may not match. So it's that's why they need to, you know, try other people.
Yeah. The landing page, it makes a big difference, right? Because if they have like a low quality landing page, then they might not get as many opt-ins, or if their offer just is something that people don't want to buy, then that would be an issue too. So, I mean, and selling so many, you know, email orders and solo ads, you know, I've been able to kind of tell like what's a good landing page and what's a good offer. And I'm able to actually kind of
consult. Because you're seeing how your traffic is reacting to those customers that are getting
results. And so now I'm at the point where I'm able to actually kind of consult with my clients and say, well, this page doesn't really look like it'll convert well. Maybe you want to, you know, change it up a little bit.
This is amazing that you brought that up, because what you just said right now is exactly the question that I asked you prior, which you hit the nail right on the spot, is that this is how you made the training personable for you. Like this is how you found your way around it. You ran that business. You followed up with your customers. And it's all simple stuff. I don't want people to think like, oh my God, what do I do? Simple. I got to follow up with my customers? Yeah, man, just send an email.
A three-sentence email. Yeah.
It's simple. Like you want to run a business, make all that money, you got to do something, right?
Right.
So, and like now you understood from the customers that got results. You looked at their landing page and now you know how a landing page works. So now, from my experience, and this may be something you could use, or maybe you're already using it, when to turn more customers into repeat customers, when you get those first-time customers or brand new customers, you can look at their landing page before you even run that traffic for them and let them know, hey, look, with my traffic, this is going to work well or it's not going to work well and you need to do this, so you can get more people the results they're looking for so they can easily become repeat customers, maybe at a higher rate than before, because now you understand what your traffic is doing for your customers or what converts. So that's a very good thing. So, okay, final question, and then we can have a free-for-all conversation if you want to talk about anything else or whatever that you like. And again, I don't mean to put you on the spot. If you don't want to answer this, you don't have to. Rough estimates, rough numbers is absolutely fine. It don't matter. But to date, sorry, I don't know why I started coughing. To date, how long has it been since you actually started running your business, and how much have you made to date? Rough estimates are okay, like I said, and if you don't mind sharing, if you do, you don't have to. And how much did you spend on paid ads, which now we know you probably didn't, but if you did, if you want to share that. And basically, how much did you do free advertising or paid ads to make sales? And also, how much work did you have to put into your business to start getting all those sales? And what was your experience with following the training to fulfill customer orders?
Okay, and that was a loaded question.
It's a fully loaded question. So basically, to simplify it, what were the sales? You don't even have to give like figures, just like a general idea.
Yeah.
What were the sales figures like? Did you do any paid ads? How much?
Yeah.
Because now, I mean, if you spent $1,000 on paid ads, but you made, you know, $1,200, that means you only made $200. So that's not really good. So I want people to get the raw, real, everything. And basically, how simple was it to fulfill the orders? Which again, you were amazing. You touched on everything. Honestly, I should have not even written this because you answered the stuff before I even asked it. So thank you.
Yeah. I mean, so I think I purchased you from you about 4 months ago. I don't think I actually really got started till like I took a month to just kind of go back through the training and I wanted to strategize a little bit. But over the last 3 months, I would say I made close to $15,000. So probably roughly about
in a 2 month period.
In a 3 month period.
In a 3 month period, $15,000.
Yeah.
That's amazing. So congratulations. Congratulations. So you could easily say, I'm not going to be held liable to the FTC. I'm just kidding.
If I put,
you made $15,000 in 90 days. So we can say about a little less than $6,000 a month if you were to like divide it up.
Yep.
Okay. That's amazing. Congratulations, man. I hope you make a million times more.
Thank you.
Honestly. No. Yes, I provided the tools and the resources, but I didn't get those sales for you. You got them for yourself. So It's thank you, and I mean this, thank you for believing in me enough that you put your own time to run this business, because you didn't know you were going to make any money or that much money until you actually started doing it.
Yeah.
So I like to thank you for putting your faith in me and actually following along and doing it and seeing the results you're seeing. And I hope it quadruples in the next couple months, even more than that. Honestly, I wish you all the best.
Yeah. So it'll definitely explode. Like, it kind of starts that the trickling of orders, and then like at some point it'll just explode and it just kind of keeps going and keeps going.
I want to ask as this, from the $15,000 or whatever that number is, how much of that do you think came from repeat customers, like percentage wise?
Yeah, I would probably say maybe 70%.
That's the key right there. That's the key.
60 or 70% of those were repeat business. So,
and like, that's how you build that residual from repeat. That's amazing, man. Honestly, I'm
and in terms of paid and free ads, most of this was like free traffic, honestly. I mean, very little was put into like paid advertising.
That's amazing.
It was mostly all profit. It's all profit, really.
Well, I mean, you got the 55 to 60% profit margin, or where you're, because the more people buy, the better the profit margins get, right?
Exactly.
So, because it all depends on that math. So that's amazing. And, well, I'm so happy for you, man. Really. I really, really am. You froze again. That's okay. Couple seconds and we'll be back on. You're back on. So,
okay.
Yeah. I'm done asking you everything here. Thank you so much for answering clearly. For everyone else to hear too. Is there anything you want to touch on? Anything you want to say? Anything you want to ask? You could plug in your website, because I'll probably make the one that goes on YouTube. We'll have all that information there anyways. If people want to buy traffic from you, where do you want them to go? MikeBashi.com, or I'm just I'm kidding. Where do you want them to go?
Yeah, definitely. They can go over to trafficbyjohn.com.
Trafficbyjohn.com.
Yeah.
That's amazing. And they can get all the information.
Yeah, they can buy traffic from me.
I'm acting like we didn't build it for you. So,
yeah.
So Traffic by John, right? Okay. Trafficbyjohn.com. And that's John with no H. I'm going to put it. People are going to see it. But just if people are just listening, trafficbyjohn.com. And my great friend will hook you guys up with amazing traffic.
Yeah, absolutely. And for any of your clients that may be on the fence, or if they have any questions, or any current clients that you may have that are struggling to like get their business off the ground, like, they can reach out to me. They can go to the website. They can check me out on YouTube as well. And I'm happy to help.
Thank
any,
you for that. Thank you for that.
Current clients or anybody that's on the fence that have any additional questions for me.
That's amazing. I thank you so much, John. Thank you so much for doing this, brother.
No problem,
and I appreciate your time. We're almost at an hour. Well, we spoke before that. So I really appreciate you, man. Thank you so much. And again, thank you for agreeing to do this. And I wish you in a month from now, we talk, or we always talk on Skype. It doesn't matter. But next time we talk, I want to hear that it's now $30,000.
Yeah, I would love that.
$50,000. Can't wait till that happens. That's amazing. Yep. Great job, man. Okay, cool, thank you so much, and you take
care. Thank you. All right, take care. All right, bye.
I'm the champion. I can not be stopped. I can't stop. I can't. This is my world. It cannot be rocked. You can't rock my world, son. Took a lot of work just to reach the top. Did a lot of climbing that I made it. Good luck to those who want to see me.